Are you visiting Rhodos for the very first time and wondering what are the best things to do on this island? Let me tell you. This is the 7-day travel guide to take the max out of your holiday and see the most places and how to manage your time. Your bags are packed, you step on a plane and you land in Diagoras airport. So what's next? You have four options to get to your hotel. And the first option is to get a transfer. The second option is to take a taxi. The third option is to rent a car. Or the fourth option, you can step on a bus. Or the fifth one, you can walk. Taxi and transfer prices from Diagoras airport to Rhodos city is around 30 euros. Bus ticket price is 3.5 euros, but from this year, 2024, you can't buy the ticket from the bus. You have to pre-buy it or buy it from the ticket stand. The easiest way is to buy a bus ticket is to buy it online. And the fourth option is to rent a car, that there are plenty of options on the island who rents a car and even bring it to you. You just made it to your hotel, so what to do in the first day? If I were you, I would take the first day really slow, because you just came from work and you are on your well-deserved vacation. So go on a beach, walk, find a nice taverna where you can find local food. Just relax, because you just came here and you have to turn your mind into vacation mode. The second day, I would take the whole day and go to see and visit Rhodos old town, because there is so much to see and do. Then I would go and walk around old town, because there is a huge wall around the old town, and for me it took 30 minutes to walk all the road. It's very long, but it's worth it. And also take a stroll in old town itself, because you can find really cool shops, crafts, some restaurants. But if you're looking for a restaurant, please keep in mind that if you see a big boot signs everywhere, big cocktails, rather don't go there if you like your money, because you get a huge cocktail for 40 or 50 euros mostly. Better is to look at Google Maps and see what the reviews say. If it's over 3 stars, it's a really good place. And if it's below, you usually get scammed or they overcharge you. My personal favorite is Taverna Costas, which is about 300 meters away from Hippocrates Square, which is the biggest square in Rhodos old town. I would look for tavernas, because they are owned usually by local people. And they don't overcharge you and they offer the best Greek experience food-wise. I would visit the Palace of Grand Masters, and the price is around 10 euros for entrance fee. The second, I would visit the clock tower to see the beautiful view of old town. The price is around 5 euros. And also I would visit archaeological museum, which is around 4 or 5 euros entrance fee. After you visited old town, go outside the old town and explore some Rhodos new town. Because there is Mandraki port, where you can find a lot of boat trips. Find yourself your boat trip for the third day. Because third day is the day where you want to go on a boat trip. After that, you can visit 90s cinema in New Town. and also aquarium and windy beach. The third day is perfect day for a boat trip. And if you bought your ticket the day before from Mandraki port, then you have a boat trip to go to. If you don't want to buy a boat trip from Mandraki port, then there are a lot of options online. And if you go to my webpage loonitravels.com, then there I have over 200 experiences and boat trips you can choose from. Keep in mind, if you buy through this link, you support me and I get like 5% commission out of it. But the other option is to go to Mandraki port and choose the best boat trip you like. I would go and see Simi Island, because the speedboat is fast, it goes there in 1 hour. You can explore the Simi Island for 3 hours. And after that you come back and visit the most beautiful bay, St. George Bay, in near Simi. So it's totally worth it. Or the other options are like 6 hour boat trips where you have all included drinks, food, you can snorkel, swim, and usually like 3 swim stops. So it's a perfect day on sea. Day 4. You usually want to take it easy, because the earlier day, the boat trip was a long day and maybe exhausting. So take the 4th day to go on a beach, relax, eat some good food, drink some good cocktails, and just enjoy. As you see, even it's a windy day today, it's amazing view and the water is always warm, so go swimming. The 5th day is the perfect day to explore the whole island. And one option is to rent a car and go around the island yourself and see the most popular spots. Or the second option is to find my island trip and I can be your driver for a day, so you can enjoy the surroundings and you don't have to deal with Greek traffic, because sometimes it's chaotic. The island trip is usually 8 hours up to 12 hours, depending on the time you want to spend on each spot. But after island trip, you have seen like 90% of Rhodes or the island. So you have visited most of the places. And if you come with me, you will have a fun time. I'm just your driver, but I have some cool stories to talk about my YouTube journey and all the places I have explored. So go to loonitravels.com and find island trip and contact us. If you rent a car and want to explore the island yourself, then we took the time and put together Rhodes travel checklist, where you can find 22 best places to visit with all the activities and also the best foods and things to do on the island, and it costs under 5 euros. It's a digital interactive PDF, so it means you can check boxes and also write on that PDF. And it's a perfect way to see the most popular and best places on the island. So take that travel checklist and go explore the whole island, because we did most of the work for you, so you don't have to do the research. The 6th day of your vacation is perfect for a beach day, because if you went on an island trip, you drove a lot and it was a really exhausting day for you. So find a nice beach, find some nice cocktails, relax, enjoy, and don't forget that you came here for vacation. So take the max out of it. And if you're in Rhodes town, then the best beaches are Elli Beach and Windy Beach. And if you want to find the sandy beach, then the first sandy beach is in Faliraki. And the most beautiful beaches are Zambika Beach and Agati Beach in South Rhodes. So relax, enjoy, and just feel the sea. It's day 7, so it's time to think about going home. The last time you can go and eat something good, go to the beach for the last time, say goodbye to your new friends. And I hope you enjoyed your holiday. And don't forget to go on our webpage, loonitravels.com, and find out our travel checklist there, and also some cool Greece-themed mugs and more products that we have there. So if you find this video useful, consider liking this video or commenting something. And I hope you enjoyed your vacation, and go and start booking your next holiday in Rhodos.